So in today's lecture, we shall be discussing about the critical appreciation of the poem, The Cherry Tree by the poet Ruskin Bond. Now this particular question, the critical appreciation is of the weightage 4 marks. So let us discuss the different points about the poem. Now there are many types the critical appreciation can be explained, but we shall follow the most common method on all. So let us begin now. So let's discuss about the following points. The first point is about the poem, information of the poem, then the poet, name of the poet, some information about him, the theme of the poem, poetic style used, language of the poem. Sixth point is poetic device. Seventh, the special feature of the poem. Eighth is the moral message that we get from the poem. And finally, my opinion, that is how do you feel about the poem, your experience with the poem. The poem is an adaptation from the famous book, The Cherry Tree. The poem is about the poet's ecstasy over a tree which he planted 8 years ago and he later forgot about it. He expressed his joy of growing it and expresses his amazement of the tree growing against all odds into a large tree. He finally expresses his satisfaction of owning a cherry tree, which he dreamt 8 years ago. Here above the poem, we understand the poet's connection with the cherry tree. His dream of growing a cherry tree, which he saw 8 years ago, and finally, without any external help, without any help from the poet or anybody, how the cherry tree grew into such a wonderful big cherry tree. Now let us discuss about the poet. Ruskin Bond is a famous Indian essayist, writer and journalist. He has written over 30 books and was very famous among the children. He has won the Sahitya Academy Award for his work in literature in India. He has also won the prestigious Padma Shri Award in the year 1999. Speaking about Ruskin Bond, he was a very versatile writer. His books were mostly influenced by the nature and his keen observation was remarkable. In the particular poem, you can understand his power and his presence of mind. While reading the particular poem or studying the poem, you could actually see the particular cherry sapling growing in front of you into a big cherry tree. This is the power of Ruskin Bond and his versatile writing. So let's see the next point. The theme of the poem can be inspiration and courage. The poet had a desire to have his own cherry tree, so he placed one and forgot about it. So here, the inspiration that we should have, or we get the inspiration, is from the cherry tree. In spite of so many threats, the tree grew and the cherry blossomed on it, and now the tree has transformed into a big cherry tree. It is standing tall and now bears ripe and sweet cherries. So this is what we have to learn from this particular poem. This is the story of the cherry tree. Against all odds, we have seen in the poem, sometimes the goat ate all the leaves, sometimes the gardener cut the leaves, sometimes due to rain. So something or the other happened, but the tree is standing tall and it is standing on its own feet without any external help. The particular poem is written in the form of a narration. In this particular form, some things are described in a continuous order, one thing after the another, which leads to the next part. The poet describes the nature and the amazing story of the cherry sapling, which against all odds transformed into a big cherry tree. While learning about the poem, we have seen that each stanza has led us to the next stanza. In the first stanza, we have seen the poet's attitude towards planting his own cherry tree. In the continuous form, we have seen the problems faced by the cherry tree. And finally, in the last stanza, we see how the cherry tree, against all odds, started showing its result. It fought against everything and finally, it had its own fruits. And how the poet was happy to see the ripe fruits on the cherry tree. The poet has utilized a number of poetic devices, so let's discuss some of them. The first poetic device is personification. It was very small, 5 months child. The 10th line, the poet has given the attributes of a child to the tree. The second is the metaphor. In the same line from the above, the cherry tree is indirectly compared to a small 5 months child. The next poetic device or figure of speech is antithesis. Second stanza, line 3, who watched wandering while time and rain. Here the consonant sound W is repeated more than twice. The next is antithesis. Second stanza, line 7 and 8, came back thinner, rather poorer, but a richer by a cherry tree at my door. Here two opposites are used in the same line. So let us see the next figure of speech, which is climax. Now the final poetic device is climax. Second stanza, second last lines, pink, fragile, quick to fall. Here it means that the cherry tree has completely grown now, and this is the very final form. Let us see the special feature of the poem, which is the poem is written in simple language. Now if you can start reading from the very first line to the very last line, we never felt that the language of the poem is really hard. The poem is written in free verse and a number of poetic devices have been used. Yes, there is no rhyming scheme in this particular poem. The poet has tried to use simple language, whereas simple things you find in nature. We can see the great observation of this particular writer, Ruskin Bond. His observation about how the tree would feel by the rains, how it would feel when the gardener cut it, how it would feel when it was very small, how it started to move its arm when it was growing. Or you can also see his description about the different seasons. So Ruskin Bond has utilized a number of small things which are found around in nature in his particular poetry. This is the power of narration, the method of narration, where one thing has led us to the next thing. As we go through the different stanzas, we see the numbers of the lines are uneven, but we didn't feel at any point that this particular poem is boring. This is the power of his narration method, that the poet's power of description is remarkable. Here, the poet has given such a wonderful message to never give up. He gives the example of his personal cherry tree, who grew up to become a strong cherry tree. Now this is the beauty of this particular poem. The final message that the poet gives us to be is, we should be optimistic in our life and we should never give up. We all have problems in our life, but we should learn to overcome all the problems in our life and achieve our final form. So we are finally to the last part, that is the opinion. I like the poem very much. I feel motivated and inspired. I will try my level best to achieve success in my life and always have a positive outlook in my life. That is, I will always try to be optimistic in my life and achieve all the goals, whichever dreams my parents have seen for me, I have seen for me, or my friends have seen for me. Finally, one day I will achieve my dreams and I will achieve my goal.